Hey guys, I got a new build for you. Man, I love this build so much, it is insane. You guys got the, what's it called? What was my last video? Oh yes, the Shielded Strike, my Malignant Scourge Axe build. You guys hit that light goal. I'm pretty fast at that. So, I will keep my promise. Here is my Warpike build. Does a lot of wound damage. I have actually hit a 10k with this thing. It was insane, man. It's not actually on video, but I came close with the clips I have. So yeah, check it out. Here it is, boys. We have the Warpike build. I call this the Hurtful Stick. Yes, you heard it, the Hurtful Stick. I literally came up with that on the fly. Well, not here on the fly. I mean, like before I decided to make the video, I was trying to figure out a name. I said the Hurtful Stick, and it fits perfectly with this build. This thing hurts, truly. Look at it. Overpower, Predator, Rage, Savagery, Berserker, Discipline, Parasitic for healing, and Zeal. But how did I put it on? What armor do I have? Lantern. That's a weird one. We probably haven't seen that before, because you haven't. I only put Embermane's Rupture on Warpikes, as I said in my axe build video. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's called the Shielded Strike. All right, let's begin. First, we have the Togedoro's Warpike, Pyroclastic Envoy. All right, you have to slay Togedoro for this in the Blaze Escalation 10 through 50. Takes a lot to do that, but you know, nothing ventured, nothing gained. No pain, no gain. All right. I put Parasitic and Berserker. Three Parasitic because once you take damage, well, enough damage, you have to get a small portion of damage taken, and instead of having it taken off entirely, it's taken off in like 10 seconds. You gain lifesteal while taking the delayed damage. It's actually pretty nice. Because if you continually attack, you can actually stay at a high enough health not to die next time you get hit. And it continues throughout the entire run, you know? Three Berserker, Prismatic Cell, reduces your max health, but dealing damage stacks increased damage dealt for a short period. You get 10 stacks, as it says here on the Three Berserker, you get 2% damage for 3 seconds. So you'll be getting 20 percent damage for 10 seconds. I mean, for 3 seconds every time you hit the behemoth, but you lose 150 health. So yeah, that, oh my bad, wrong thing. Now going on to the special, Reckless Leap. In order to get this, you need to beat the trials. I think you need 500 steel marks to get this. I really think it's steel marks. If it's gilded marks, tough turkey toenails, you're still gonna have to do it, but if you want this build, that is. But this Reckless Leap does 1,500 damage based on the distance and your ammo quality. Basically, if you are very close to the behemoth and you have it and your ammo quality as at 100%, you will do 1,500 damage. But if you're further and it's still at a higher quality, you'll be doing a lot more damage. And with this build, I hit that 10k. I was dead surprised, guys. Dead surprised. I've hit 7ks, 6ks, all that. But the 10k was, and it was in DPS. I don't even understand that myself. Now, the mod is Executioner Spearhead. You could use Barbed Spearhead to gain more wound damage. But I use Executioner Spearhead because it already has enough wound damage. And every time you wound or assist a wound to a behemoth part, you gain 6% damage for 2 minutes. And it stacks up to 10 times. So I don't even think that a behemoth has 10 body parts to wound. So if you're on an escalation and you get the stacks up to 10, you'll be doing 60% more damage for 2 minutes. Love it, don't you? And the bond, of course, would be the Inferno's Arrow. Never use the charred spear. No, well, don't use any Cherrig weapons. Or I call it Cherig. I've heard Odo say that it's Charog. I don't know. Whatever you like to call it. Ember Pike isn't that bad, but we really don't need Evasive Fury. We need Overpower around these parts. That's why I put on the Inferno's Arrow. You get this from Hellion. He's not that hard to slay. Scorchstone Hellion is annoying, but a regular Hellion isn't that hard to defeat. It comes with 3 Overpower, and every 8th hit does 225 damage and Major Blaze damage. So with this Warpike, you'll be able to set the Behemoth on fire, because it's as fast as Chain Blades, meaning that it'll be able to put debuffs on the Behemoth. So that's enough of the weapon. Let's go to the armor. We have the Tragic Echo. Now, I don't do this a lot. I don't put Tragic Echo that often. But the reason why is because the last update gave the Tragic Echo all the exotics. Gave all of the exotics perks. New perks. So this one comes with Rage. I would usually put the Dark Watch, but now the Tragic Echo has Rage. And it also comes with a Power Cell, the same thing as the. Oh, what am I doing? The. Dark Watch. So in order to do this, you need to slay Shroud, and then you also have to get elemental elemental and neutral kinds of things, like neutral Fury Tail or elemental Fury Tail or elemental tail gem, you know, those kinds of things. But I put Overpower in here as the cell, because it increases damage against staggered behemoths. This thing actually does stagger. I wasn't expecting it to do that a lot of stagger damage, but I had a weekly challenge that said 250 250k stagger damage to enraged behemoths, and I got this thing down in that thing down in no time at all. I was surprised myself. But now let's go to the chest plate. We got the Quill Spike Jacket. I don't do this often. Well, this is the first Warpike build you've ever seen me put out here on YouTube. Every Warpike build I ever use, I need to have Savagery on it, because as you can see here, 100% more damage versus wounded parts. I have 6 Savagery, works perfectly. Now I put Predator on it because it increases the damage after avoiding damage for a short time. What I tell you guys, do not get hit. You get No, where's my predator? Yeah, you get 35% more damage after not taking damage for 15 seconds. But when you get hit, you lose the bonus. And then you have to wait another 15 seconds of not getting hit in order for it to work again. Oh my goodness, what is wrong with me? Now the arms, I put Malkarion's Grasp. It comes with Predator, and I put Savagery on it, giving us our Savagery and Predator. And then Volcanic Treads, get this from Charog. I said Charog now, hilarious. It comes with 3 Rage, giving us our 6 Rage over here, since the Tragic Echo comes with Rage. I forgot to tell you where I got the Overpower from. I put Overpower. Where did I put Overpower? Yeah, I put Overpower here on the Tragic Echo, and Overpower comes from the Inferno's Arrow, because the bond also comes into play. And then I put Discipline on the Volcanic Treads, because it limits us to half health, increases our critical strike chance, putting the Rage into play. Now the Lantern. I chose Embermane's Rupture. I said this in my Malignant Scourge video. It works amazingly with Warpikes, bro. It just works awesome. And then the Lantern Tap gives you, I don't know how much attack speed exactly, but it does a good deal of attack speed. The hold creates a fireball that explodes after 5 seconds, and it deals 850 blaze damage. This thing will work perfectly against Frost Behemoths, of course, the way everything works. The utility cell I put is 3 zeal because it increases the effectiveness of lantern tap abilities. You could put cascade if you want. Don't put anything else. Either zeal or cascade. I chose zeal because it allows me to get more attack speed, and attack speed works perfectly with this warp ike, as I continually say. Now, the lanterns. The only two I command you to take are Insight and Blitz. Frenzy does not matter. You can take anything else that you want, anything at all, but you have to take Insight and Blitz. The Blitz for attack speed and Insight for more wound damage. That's why I said it doesn't. I don't recommend the Barbed Spearhead. I took Executioner Spearhead. And you also have to get the Executioner Spearhead from Trials, you know. That one I know for a fact takes Steel Marks. So you'll just have to do Trials normal in order for that to work. But yeah, that's the build, guys. I'm going to show you the clips that I made of using this thing. I am a level 19. It's featuring 21 Spartan X. I am 21 Spartan X, my little bro, and this is dedicated to my little sister. She is a Warpike main, so I'm making her a build that does insane damage and insane wound damage. That's why I call it the Hurtful Stick. So guys, hear the clips.
cross for them. Still slumbers. So this will be your final battle. Thank you.
My oh my gosh, that was insane, wasn't it? You saw all that damage. The 6Ks, 5Ks. I don't believe I hit a 10K. If you did see it, post a comment down below and tell me the timestamp of where it was, so I'll look at it myself. But yeah, that's the hurtful stick for you guys. Hurts, don't it? But yeah, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash that like button with them big muscles. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button. It's free and you can always change your mind later if you don't like my videos. I'm just playing. Yeah, so if you guys want another build, like my repeaters build, get this video to give it 5 likes again. Yeah, because you guys hit that one real quick last time. But if you want it, hit that like goal real quick. All right, so that'll be it. I will see you guys next time. See ya.